Hello Kutis, how are you all? I'm happy to see you all through this video. Okay, now what I'm doing with my hands? Can you able to see this? Yes, this is a type of brain yoga. What is it? This is a type of brain yoga. Why we have to do this? It increases our memory power and concentration power. Okay, when you are doing your brain yoga, it improves your memory power and concentration power and keep our brain more active. Usually we are doing more exercise now to keep our body fit, like a way to keep our brain fit and active. You have to do this exercise daily. You have to do at your home. Shall we try now? Yes, you have to join your fingers. Yes, you have to touch your palm like this. Again, you have to join your fingers on the left hand. You have to touch your palm on the right hand. So you have to join like this. This is a brain yoga. Shall we do now? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So daily you have to practice at home and improve your brain memory power. Okay. Let me move on to the sessions. What I am doing now, I am speaking to you, right? Yes, I am speaking to you. What you are all doing? You all are watching me. You are all watching me and listening me, isn't it? Yes. So how we are watching, how we are listening and how we are speaking? By our parts, part of our body. So I am speaking through my mouth and you are listening through your ears. You are looking at me through your eyes. So these are all our parts of our body. Yes or no? Yes. What are the parts you know? What are the parts of a body you know? Yes. Head, eyes, nose, mouth, ears, hands, fingers, legs. These are the parts you know. Very good. Okay. These are all called as external parts. Okay. What are they called as? External parts. So these parts are called as external parts of our body. Can you tell some internal parts of our body? Did anyone know any internal parts? Yes, very good. Brain, heart, lungs, kidney, stomach. Oh, this much you know. Very good. So these are the internal parts of our body. So there are two parts of our body, external parts and internal parts of our body. How the internal parts works, what are their functions, how it forms, that only we are going to see in this lesson. So what is our lesson topic? Human body and organ system. What is it? Human body, organ system. So we are seeing, no, our mouth, ears, eyes, everything we are seeing, no. So this is also called as sense organs. We are feeling something, no. If anyone touch you like this, you will feel that pain, no. So that is called a, that feel you can feel through by skin. Okay, if your mother cooks something, you will take the smell. Wow, super smell. How you are smelling it? By our nose. So as you are tasting that food, no, by our tongue. So these parts are called as our sense organs. What is it? Sense organs. So we'll see our sense organs. How many types of sense organs in our body? There are 5 types of sense organs. How many parts? 5 types of sense organs. What are they? Tongue to taste. So whether it is sweet or sour or salty, we have to check the taste, no? That is by our tongue. That second one is eyes. We can see everything. What are the things around us? We can see everything by our eyes. Next one is nose, to smell something. Okay, so you are looking many flowers, no? You have to identify that flowers by its smell, identify some cooking items by its smell itself. So you can smell by our nose. Next one is skin, feeling. So if it is very hot, we can feel that hotness, no, heatness we can feel. If it is very cold, we can feel the chillness. So everything we can feel by our skin. Last one is ears. If someone is talking to you, you are listening by our ears. So these are the 5 sense organs in our body. Simply we can remember this as tense. What is it? Tense. tense in lower classes you study no in English. That word tense you hear no? Yes. So you have to remember that tense. T for tongue, E for eyes, N for nose, S for skin, and I one more E for ears. So these are the five types of sense organs. Okay. Now we'll see that next one. Organ system. How the organ systems will form? There are so many cells in our body. There are large number of cells in our body. There are small cells in our body. So all these cells together form a tissue. Tissue means a chinna tasa madri or layer mari form avu. So all the cells are combined to form a tissue. Then different types of tissues form an organ. Okay, there are so many types of tissues. The different types of tissues form an organ. Then these organs are combinedly form as an organ system. What is it? Organ system. So these organ systems are there make a human body. So all the cells are making a tissues. Then different types of tissues makes an organ. Then different organs makes an organ system, and finally it forms a human body. So this is the structure of our human body. So apart from that, there are so many systems are there. Here we see that organ system, no? So there are so many organ systems are there. What are the systems are here? We'll see one by one. So here, see how many systems are there? Can we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So how many systems are there in our body? 7 systems. What are they? That first one is skeletal system. What is it? Skeletal system. And second one is muscular system. What is it? Muscular system. And third one is digestive system. Digestive system. And fourth one is circulatory system. What is it? Circulatory system. And next one is respiratory system. Respiratory system. And next one is the nervous system. The nervous system. And last one is the excretory system. What is the last one? The excretory system. While reading itself, you have to read by a syllable. Syllable means you have to separate and read. Skeletal. Skeletal. So like away, if you read means it will be easy for you to remember and it won't forget. So can we tell one more time the systems? Yes, first one is skeletal system, second one is muscular system, and third one is the digestive system, and next one is circulatory system, and next one is respiratory system, and next is nervous system, and that last one is excretory system. So these are the different types of systems in our human body. So first one we'll see about the skeletal system. Skeleton means we all know in more movies, that horror movies, everything we'll see that skeleton. No, some movies the skeleton will dancing. Yes, skeleton means that is a joining of bones. So there are so many bones in our human body. All the bones are joined together and it forms a frame like structure. That is called as skeleton. Okay, so the skeleton, there are how many bones in our body? Did anyone know how many bones in our body? Yes, very good. There are 206 bones in our body. So there are 206 bones. These all bones are joined together and form a framework. That frame is called as a skeletal. What is the use of the skeletal? What is its function? Did you know? What is its function? Yes, the skeletal system protects our internal organs. That internal organs already we see, no? What are the internal organs? Brain, heart, lungs, everything is vital, no? Yes. So the skeletal protects our internal parts of our body. For example, brain. What is the part of that bone here? It is called as skull. What is it? Skull. So the brain is protected by our skull. Like away, the heart and lungs is protected by our rib cage. So these are the bones of the name of the bones, skull, rib cage. There are some other bones are also there. So backbone. What is backbone? நம்மளோட முதுகுல ஸ்ட்ரைட்டா ஒரு எலும்பு இருக்கறியா, that is called as backbone. So அந்த backbone இல்லேன்னா நம்மளால என்ன பண்ண முடியும்? Can we stand straight like this? No, without backbone we can't stand, we have to bend. So without bones, how we are looking like without bones? Can you imagine? Without bones we are look like a jelly. It will be collapsed. No, so the all the tissues will be formed, joined together, it look like jelly. So without bones we can't do any work, we can't stand straight, we can't walk anything. Okay, so skeleton is the must and it protects our body. So next system is muscular system. What is it? Muscular system. The muscular system helps our body to move. Okay, helps our body to move. It is a stretchy like band, stretchy band, that rubber band we know, no? So it is elastic, like if you pull it out again it will be comes like this. So like a way, it's a like a stretchy band. So how it look like? So it's our muscles can work all the work of our body. If you are walking, if you are jumping, if you are even that blinking of our eyes, that is also a work of our muscles. Okay, the blinking of our eyes to jumping, walking, doing all that works. Our facial expressions, if you are smiling, means what will do? Our skin will come like this and again come back to your question. If you are smile like this, what will do? The skin will be extended. Okay, so it is a stretchy like structure. So the muscles are gives the movement of our body, helps us to gives the movement of our body. If you are blinking your eyes, your eyelashes will be moving, no? So that is also with the help of muscles. Not only our outer parts, it not helps us to outer parts, it also helps the internal parts that to do our functions. For example, if you are taking food, if you are, it is growing through our food pipe, so that is also your muscles. Okay, so that muscular system helps us to all work in our body. The next one is digestive system. Digestion, digestion that we all know, jeerna agala jeernam aayiduchu appdi solluvallaya at your home, your parents and grandparents usually use that word jeernam. So that is a digestive system. So this digestive system, it starts from our mouth. We are having food in our mouth, right? Yes, so we are having food in our mouth. So is that work finish it with your mouth itself? Nama saapradha appadi adoda stop aiduma and the work? No, that food what we are eating is enters into your stomach through the food pipe. What is it? Food pipe. So nama saapradha saapadu food pipe mulama it enters into our stomach. In that stomach there is a small intestine and large intestine. What is intestine? Kudal. Kudal solluvala vaitukulla kudal irukke ellathukku theriyum illaya. There are two types of intestines, small and large. Siru kudal, perum kudal solluvala illaya. Yes, that is intestine. So there are two types of intestine, small and large intestine. So the food we eat enters into our stomach and it digests. Digest means it has to break down into a smaller substance. சின்ன சின்னதாக நம்ம கிரைண்டரில் போட்டு எப்படி அரையும் அந்த மாதிரி நம்ம ஸ்டொமக்கில் போயிட்டு நம்ம ஃபுட்டெல்லாம் சேர்ந்து கிரைண்ட் ஆகி இட் பிரேக்கன் இன்ட்டு ஸ்மாலர் சப்ஸ்டன்ஸ் அண்ட் தட் எனர்ஜி தட் வில் எனர்ஜி அண்ட் நியூட்ரியன்ஸ் வில் பாஸ் த்ரூ அவர் ஹோல் பாடி த்ரூ அவர் பிளட். ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த டைஜஸ்டிவ் சிஸ்டம். இட் பிரேக்ஸ் டவுன் த ஃபுட் வாட் வி ஈட் அண்ட் இட் கிவ்ஸ் எனர்ஜி, இட் சப்ளைஸ் எனர்ஜி டு ஆல் பார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அவர் பாடி. த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் சர்க்குலேட்டரி சிஸ்டம். வாட் இஸ் இட்? சர்க்குலேட்டரி சிஸ்டம். The circulatory system means it includes the heart, blood and blood vessels. What is blood vessels? Blood vessels means the ratta nanangal solluvom illaya, ratta nanangal nam odangu fulla irukum. So heart, blood and blood vessels. Heart, heart is the main part to transport our blood. Okay, when the heart pumps means the blood will be circulated to our body. We all know the heart will pumping. Laptop, laptop, hear some sounds, no? When you keep your hand in your heart, that some sounds will be heard. That is a heartbeat. So whenever the heart pumps, the blood will be transferred to all parts of our body through our blood vessels. So these are the function of our circulatory system. It can carry the nutrients from our food and all the energy from our food and transport to our body through the blood vessels. That is the function of circulatory system. And next one is respiratory system. Respiration. What is respiration? Uchvangrolia, that is respirations. So we are breathing in and breathe out. We are usually doing, no, daily Without breathing, can we live? No. So without breath, we can't live. So we are breathing. So what gas we are breathing in? Yes, that is oxygen. What we are gives out? Very good. Carbon dioxide. So we are breathing oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. This process is happening in our respiratory system through our lungs. So when we are breathing the air we breathe in is called as inhaled air. We are breathing in, no? So it is inhaled air, that is called as inhaled air. So that inhaled air will breathe through our nose or mouth. We can usually breathe by our nose. So that air we breathe in is enter in our nose and it enters through our windpipe. Already we saw that food pipe in digestive system, no? Like a way, there is one more pipe called as windpipe. That is used for our respiratory system. So the air we breathe in enters through our windpipe and it enters to our lungs. So through our lungs only we can breathe in a fresh air and breathe out the unwanted air. That is called as carbon dioxide. The air we breathe in is called as inhaled air and the air we breathe out is called as exhaled air. So this process is called as respiratory system. This has happened through our lungs. Okay. Next one is nervous system. Nerves. Narambugal. Theriyulaya? Nerves. Yes. The brain and spinal cord and nerves are combinedly form the nervous system. So what are the things form the nervous system? Brain and spinal cord. Brain. The brain is the main part. What's the function of the brain? Do you know that function of the brain? If someone will touch you like this, what we will react for that? You know, no, someone is touching us. We have to react at immediately. We'll turn and see, no? Why? This is happened by our brain. If anything has happened, immediately it will send message to our brain and brain will react for it immediately and responds for us. Okay. So all that happenings, all our activities, learning, everything will be happened through our brain only. So the brain is protected by our nervous system and spinal cord means that is a backbone. That is also we'll see. Okay, brain, spinal cord and other nerves. So through that nerves the brain send messages and receive messages from us. Okay, immediately will give response to us, then only we are react for that activities. What are the things that has happened? We are react for that activities. So these all activities will happen in our nervous system. For example, if you are taste something, it will be sweet. Everything will be send messages to our brain and the brain only give response and react for us. Then only we will respond to them. The last one is excretory system. What is excretory system? Exit. We know exit means it's a we are going out. That is the right excretory system. What are the things we are eating? We are eating more things. There are more nutritional foods. Everything we are eating, no? From that food, that all the nutrients and energy we are taking and which are circulated through our blood to the whole body. And the some more the unwanted things are also there. So that is that unwanted water, that is excess water, excess food, that waste materials, that is comes out through our body by sweating. Already most of them have more sweating, no? That is all the unwanted things. Well, that is waste things comes out from your skin holes. That is sweating. Then what are the other waste? That are carbon dioxide. We are breathing out carbon dioxide, no? That is also unwanted gas for our body. So that is also we are excreted. So these are the things which has happened in the excretory system. That is the lungs, kidney, these and skin. These are the three things which are in excretory system. Through our lungs, we have breathed out the unwanted gas carbon dioxide. Through our skin, we are giving out our unwanted things as sweating. So these parts taken part in the excretory system. So these are the seven types of systems. Shall we recall? Yes. First one is skeletal system. Second one. Yes, muscular system. How many muscles in our body? We see, no, already there are 206 bones in our body. How many muscles? There are 600 muscles in our body. So next one is digestive system. What are the parts taken part in digestive system? Mouth, food pipe and stomach. Stomach means small intestine and large intestine. And next one is circulatory system. In that circulatory system, heart, blood and blood vessels. Okay, these are the three parts which takes parts in the circulatory system, and it carries blood to all parts. That is, that carries the nutritional and energetic food to all parts of our body. Do you know that our heart is also made up of muscles? This is only a made up of muscles only. So this is also a movement of muscles. We saw now that muscles help us to move. So the heart beating, now bumping, that is also a movement of muscles. The next one is respiratory system. Respiratory means, we see now that okay, the air we breathe in and breathe out, everything has happened here. So we are breathing air through the nose, then through the windpipe it enters into our lungs. Yes, very good, it enters into our lungs. The nervous system. Nervous system is, the main thing is in nervous system is brain. What is it? Brain. So the brain is reacting for all our activities. So the main thing of our nervous system is brain. That last one is excretory system. The unwanted things we are giving out is called as an excretory system. For example, sweating comes from our skin and carbon dioxide we are giving out through our lungs. Okay. And you all recall this one? Yes, if you are having a book, you have to take your book and read this everything, and you have to see the sense organs also. What is the simple form of sense organs? Yes, tense. So you have to remind everything, study the spelling for those seven types of system. We will see in the next session. Thank you.